Beep, boop, beep, motherfucker. Welcome to the future. Because, I mean, think about it. We're living in it. Everything has a Bluetooth setting now. Food is more expensive than ever. And the man trying to get us onto Mars is a goddamn meme lord. So I guess, in short, the future's here. So why try to reject it, man? Let's just embrace what science has brought to us and just learn to coexist with people of all shapes, sizes, and circuit boards. And what better way to usher in this crazy technological boom than to get behind the mantle of an actual real-life virtual video game robot and experience what it's like to live as one firsthand by kicking other people's asses in a competitive fighting environment. Game on, bitches!
Okay, so what do you need to know if you're looking to main R.O.B? Well, this character is an exceptional edgeguarding character. He has a ton of moves that are effective for zoning, and his punish game can be pretty off the walls thanks to a mix of solid projectiles, heavy-hitting aerials, and a ridiculous recovery. First off, let's establish what some of his throws and aerials are good for. Let's start off with R.O.B's down throw. This move gives him the old Pennsylvania jackhammer, which is sort of like the Colorado roll down, except instead of following it up with fireworks and three donkeys, you follow it up with an up tilt, an up aerial, or an up smash. It's one of R.O.B's better setups for free damage because it buries your opponents in the ground, which lasts longer the higher percent they're at, and also allows for some fun mix-ups while they try to escape their live burial. His up throw is an effective killing tool that shoots his opponents up like a rocket, and unlike the moon landing, is actually real, and isn't a ploy by secret mole societies to get the people of Earth focused on the skies rather than putting too much thought into what's going on underground. Anyway, while you're using R.O.B's forward and back throws to chuck your opponents off the stage, be sure to admire moves like his forward aerial, which is R.O.B's fastest aerial, or his neutral down and back aerials, which use pure 100% diesel to power up his attacks, making them solid spacing and finishing moves, while also stalling or redirecting his momentum by emitting enough CO2 into the atmosphere to burn a hole the size of Argentina through the ozone. Hey, anyway, were you deprived of the irreplaceable childhood experience of playing Beyblade with your friends because the only game your friends liked to play growing up was Give Us Your Allowance or We'll Kick the Ever-Loving Shit Out of You and Leave You on the Side of the Road to Slowly Bleed Out?
Wait, you were? Wow, what a fucking loser. Well, hey, now thanks to R.O.B's down special, you can live out that experience as a fully grown adult like a real sad son of a bitch. With this move and a dominant display of literal big dick energy, R.O.B removes his penis from his body and proceeds to wind it up before he lets it rip on his opponents like a genuine, fully automated crotch rocket. Wait, actually, is that his penis? Computer, enhance that image. Yeah, okay, that's for sure a penis. There's nothing else that could be. Anyway, so R.O.B's dreidel dongle, outside of making the robo-babe swoon, is mainly a tool for spacing out your opponent and edgeguarding. You can bounce it off your opponent's ass to push them back. You can leave it by the ledge as people are trying to recover to really be a dick about that whole getting back on the stage thing. You can just pick it up and throw it right at them with your own two metallic clamps. The options are endless. When should you use them? Who knows? Use it situationally, I suppose. The only thing I do know definitively is that that thing is 100% a penis. Moving on. R.O.B's side special, the Mega Quintuple Bitch Slap. Oh, sorry, misread that. Arm Rotor grants a lot of approaching options due to its high priority and ability to reflect opponents' projectiles. It can be directed from side to side and also ends with a big ol' sucker punch to send your opponents flying so you can start edgeguarding them. It's a good move for breaking out of combos and diminishing the hours of time your opponents put into labbing their mains by just saying, you know what? Fuck your combos. While also, on top of all of this, being a nice kill option. It's an all-around solid move, although it does have a bit of end lag, so be careful when you choose to use it, and it's a good way to annoy the hell out of your opponents when they start thinking they know shit. Alright, I see the look you're giving me. I know what you're waiting for. Let me guess, you're thinking, well, wait a flab-dunk second, all of this is good information and all, but quit holding out on me, this is a robot, not a ro-bitch. And everybody knows that every cool robot in the history of cool robots can shoot lasers and shit. Cut the crap, let's skip to the good part. Well, sorry to burst your bubble, but not every robot is built like it's in a goddamn sci-fi movie. Nintendo designed this robot with the intent of making a lovable toy accessory to the NES, not a combat-ready killing machine. How about you take your outdated ideas on what does or does not qualify as a cool robot, and appreciate R.O.B. for what he was. A Trojan horse used to revitalize the North American video game market in the 80s, alright? Not every piece of technology needs to have a friggin' laser light show coming out of its asshole. Jeez. That being said, R.O.B. does have a laser beam, and it is a really solid projectile, so how does it work? Well, it's a fucking laser beam. So he shoots you with a fucking laser beam. Couldn't have figured that one out on your own, genius? Oh, and the move also bounces off of surfaces, so you can do some pro-gamer mom-grab-the-camera-level trick shots with it. But don't blow your load too quickly, because once you use it, it has to recharge before you can use it again.
But Ty, how do I know when the laser beam is charged? Do I just guess? I'm confused and frightened.
Alright, let me speak down to your level. You ever heard of Rudolph? Well, it's sort of like that. But instead of using the story of a sweet yet marginalized flying deer to turn the winter season into an economically stimulating method of monetizing people's love and affection for one another, this is the story of a former robotic cult leader who now uses his powers for good by shooting animals and children with his laser beams. Oh, I'm sorry, that actually didn't explain shit. To answer your question, the little light on the top of his head starts glowing when the attack is charged. Wait a second. Oh my goodness, well what a coinkydink, would you look at the time. That's right, looks like it's time for a good old-fashioned robot uprising. In other words, let's quit with the formalities and start talking plain and simple automaton assassination strategies, shall we? Side smash and down smash are solid, although they could have better range
damage and knockback, which is why your main smash attack you should be using is his up smash, once again thanks to the power of high-grade environmentally questionable oil. Like I said earlier, it's a good way to punish his down throw, but it's also a good punishing tool for when you're able to bait out an air dodge. But all of the smash attacks do have their own separate uses, so make sure to utilize them all when the time is right. And with all that said, I think that's everything. Time to take what you've learned and put it into practice. Train hard, shit talk harder, and play for keeps, my friend. Have fun. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more of these. I make a new episode in this series every single Monday. If you want to know more about me and the shit that I do, you can talk to me on Twitter, Facebook, my Discord server, and I also have a Twitch channel, which I'm not using yet, but it's going down as soon as I have good Wi-Fi. You better believe. Anyway, guys, again, thank you for watching. Love you dearly. Don't forget to practice proper dental hygiene, motherfuckers. Bye-bye.